Hello and greetings from Iceland. In this update, I'm going to look at what the experts are saying, and despite how confusing things look, I do have some good news, finally. And I will also be talking about the homeless people of Grindavík and the tourism in Iceland. Or is there a reason to cancel your trip? Since the Reykjanes Peninsula for the last 2 weeks can best be described as a disaster movie in slow motion. And let's start with the scientists. In my last update, I was talking about this extremely fast land uplift due to magma inflow into a sill where magma has been accumulating near the Blue Lagoon. And experts were telling us that it could be just a matter of few hours or days before the earthquakes would start again. And we might be looking at a similar scenario as we witnessed on November 10th. And it was then just 2 days ago when I was listening to an interview with Dr. Haraldur Sigurdsson, volcanologist. And he was saying that the magma dike under Grindavík has started to solidify. And if he would be one of the people living in Grindavík, he would like to be home before Christmas. Obviously putting pressure on the authorities to open up the town again. But he did, however, mention as well that if this land uplift by the Blue Lagoon would continue, we might have to deal with an eruption near the old craters called Eldvörp, which is indeed the best place for an eruption. And his colleague, Dr. Ármann Höskuldsson, he has also been saying the same thing all along. If this will develop into an eruption, it will not come up from the dike. And it was then yesterday when Professor Þorvaldur Þórðarson joined this party, but he did also leave us with plenty of room for speculation. So this different view from scientists has been putting a lot of pressure on the civil defense, where we have people who are not scientists trying to work out a risk assessment from those many voices out there. Or what experts are they going to listen to and who to ignore? So the latest news from them is that they have been getting experts from Italy. And it was finally announced last night that the civil defense had lowered the risk level for Grindavík. And this signifies that an eruption is no longer considered probable within the town itself. But we do however expect some new development when this magma inflow has lifted the land more by the Blue Lagoon. So that is where the uncertainty is now. And we still have to deal with the fact that 3,700 people fled the town, almost 1% of the nation. Those families are now scattered around the country and many of them want to move back to the parts of town that are okay when it comes to infrastructure. But we do have another underlying problem, like there was huge lack of apartments in Iceland before this disaster. Housing prices and rental prices were higher than ever before. And despite the good insurance system we have, it is only a small portion of the houses in Grindavík that can be compensated, or the houses that are by this new rift valley through town. And the rest of the houses, they are in perfectly fine condition, but useless to the owners. And this morning I was reading an interview with a representative of the biggest workplace in town saying that all his fish processing facilities are in excellent condition, just like the harbor itself, and he wants to get back to business as soon as possible. But he was also aware of the fact that we need a lot of planning before that can happen, and you also need to know where this land uplift is leading us to. And if it's going to end up with an eruption, I think that most of the people just want it over and done with, tired of waiting. And this uncertainty is so bad in many ways, since most of the people don't have the option to take the insurance money and move on. And even if the town would turn out to be a safe place to live and work, we already know that there are people who want to move back. And what awaits them is perhaps the worst rental market in Europe. So the unions have stepped in. They own a lot of holiday apartments and the banks were pressured to freeze mortgage payments and interests at least for the next 3 months, and in the meantime the government is buying them some time. Time to come to the conclusion that practical people did come to very soon after this disaster, or the fact that we just need several hundred houses that can be assembled fast. So the housing problem is still unsolved. And I'm ending this today with some tourist information, since I've been hearing about cancellations. And it is actually quite sad if people are doing it for the wrong reason or lack of reliable information, which has sometimes been the case. And there is very little chance of air traffic disruption. The three volcanic eruptions since 2021, they didn't cause any delays at all or due to the nature of those eruptions on the peninsula. And if it weren't for this unfortunate location where we are facing considerable damage, the media discussion would not be as scary as it has been this time. I do understand why people are cancelling, but I advise them to look beyond the headlines, since December can be a beautiful month and a wonderful time to visit Iceland. And I think that the next 10 days will decide the outcome for the town of Grindavík, if it was just a short lifting episode or if it's going further, and if there will be no eruption and the magma solidifies without any new inflow, the people in Grindavík might get some good news before Christmas. But if it's going to erupt, let's hope it just occurs soon so we can get it over with. But I can at least say that things look a bit better now, and we have to be thankful for that. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.